looking for a job. I'm really building some kind of future with family. But you find sometimes that that is amiss. And the child would walk away from that and find himself into difficulties or making decisions that are different from that which you, as a parent, have surmised. And we really have to train our children how to work with those differences. Because your child can leave home with a particular temperament and reach the bus or the taxi, and somebody says something or watch them somewhere, and the next thing they hold on to them and beat them and kill them. And you're like, my child? Because we have not sat down and gone through the whole psyche of how to work out these differences. What are we saying then? What should we say? How should we say it? Put them to sit. Carry them out maybe to a restaurant, to the park. Sit with them. Ask them, what do you want to do? Where do you want to work? What's expected? What kind of work that is? You ever thought of that work? Do you know what that work entails? Find out, because some of them are daft. Did I use that word? Some of them are ignorant of that kind of employment. And so therefore, it's important to understand what's happening. It's important to understand how we are working that out. So let's see if we can plan our children's future. Don't let your child plan its future by itself. It does not work for good. We need to be involved. We need to sit them down. We need to say where. We need to tell them, okay, if that's where you want to go, what it entails. Let's begin to find some space. Identify. Strategize. Because expectations and the outcomes need to be aligned. Most times, outcomes are not what the expectations are. Because, excuse me, it's different. Because the people out there, where the outcomes are quite different in their own cultures and traditions. When they come into your space, they ask silly questions. Or did I say silly? No. Ask different questions. Now, we might find it silly, but it's a different question. It's a different attitude, different thought. So it's important for us to really re-identify the way forward as to how to establish these children. I keep saying children, by now they're young adults. But can I use the word children? Let's go get out of it. Your children, your young adults, your people, who you want to do so well, but you have to invest in that too. Let me go a little further. How do we work out even their concept of finances? What's their concept of payment or remuneration? Everybody's dressing up, everybody's buying, everybody's taking big time, looking good. I want a job to do what? Get money, no! When you want a job to get money, you're going to fail. Because when you get money in your hand, you really do not know what to do with it. And you can waste it. And after 10 years, you have no money. So that I want you to see, how do you work your togetherness? How do you work your future in terms of how am I bringing myself into a space where we can collaborate the concept finances with the aspect of growth and building our future. So it's important to note, it's important to establish. What have I noted? Well, I have children. What am I noting? They're growing up. What else am I noting? They have a job. What else am I noting? They're exposed to all new traditions and experiences. What else am I noting? They behave differently. They behave differently. How else do I know that they're noting? I wonder if they're noting anything. There's a go-lucky thing somewhere there. Everybody do their own thing, whatever. I don't care. No, we have to care. We have to synchronize with a puppet. We have to synchronize with daddy and mommy. We have to synchronize with granny. Oh, granny. Oh, that's our next story. And aunties. So again, the community extends. How we are working all of this is important because everybody has something in their mind for you and for how you should work it. I presented to you the concept of planning, not so much as budgeting, but planning as understanding the expectations of how to define oneself, to define one's own gratifications, to define one's own concepts of growth and the concepts of how one wants to be. Who does one want to be? I can't say in my life that I had a plan for who I want to be. But I knew I wanted to make a positive impact on my environment. I wanted to make sure that the people around me were positively identified and there was some kind of growth that was important, not just for me, but for them. So I made sure that my lifestyle was affecting people positively. So I started to think about how I could do this. I started to want to work along people. I went to technical school. I was involved with people. So we would laugh and talk. Then I changed from technical school to biblical school. But wherever I went, it was not about the school. It was about me impacting people. And I think it has proven well for me today that it was all that I'm doing, that I am still impacting people. I am not really concerned about whether I have $100, $1 million, whether I have good shoes or good pants. I want to know, whatever I have, how can I use that to impact you? You're asking the question, what do you want? It must look good. No, hold on. You must behave good. You must talk good. You must connect good. You must improve good. Those are the things that are important for your future. How do you build a community? By the time I reached 35 and having been married and a family and having grooming them, it was important for me again to continue with whatever sphere was in, to honor and work on that. So by the time I became a lecturer, again, it was not about my accolades or what I had earned. It's about me impacting the students' lives. How can I make a difference in their lives?